Starting lineups, Nichols, Ruoff, Alexander, Young, and Summers for West Virginia. For Clemson, it'll be Hamilton, Hammonds, Casey Rivers, James Mays, and the big fellow, the freshman in the middle, Trevor Booker. Had an outstanding game on Tuesday. Booker will jump it up against Joe Alexander, and the championship game of the MasterCard NIT is underway. It'll be West Virginia on offense.
And Ron Franklin, Fran Frisilla. Clemson Goose.
Key for Clemson is to be very physical on all those cuts, Bill.
I think you got to lead the cuts too frequently, you know, and then step back on the three.
Jumper with 6 seconds on the clock, and they knock it down.
And unfortunately, the 1-3-1, you don't see enough of it.
Well, that's one of the things Clemson talked about. If you guard well, Ron, and give up some missed shots, they can't set up that 1-3-1.
You see the quick hands, they'll trap occasionally over there.
Coach John Beilein, the head coach at West Virginia, will discuss early on in the telecast, getting a lot of attention from a Big Ten school in the Midwest, up around Michigan, I think.
And he was saying to us, why not us winning the championship? Let's feel sorry for somebody else.
Exactly. Yeah, that's right.
Grab hold of it.
Not just the fact that we were here and had a chance. Lefty, three-pointer, got it.
Can we pick him, huh?
Well, it sounds simple, but if you make some shots against that zone, you'll loosen it up, especially from the corners.
You know, for people not in basketball, it sounds trite, but it's so true. It just impacts everything. You look, the way you guard, if you can knock them down. Good ball movement. They really space, make you work. Tough shot.
10 seconds on the shot clock, taken down by Clemson. The Tigers will push it, and they'll turn it over. Oliver Purnell has done a really outstanding job at Clemson, his fourth season. Started off the year 17-0. We all know about a couple of hiccups early in conference play, one of which we'll show you and talk about, which never should have happened, but did.
Hey, what's amazing, guys, 18-0 in non-conference games this year. That's pretty remarkable.
And a pretty good start this season at 17, right?
Yes,
kind of got a little knockdown on the sideline. But, you know, the similarities in both coaches, Fran, is amazing. They've been very successful every place they've been, and
started
up the scale.
Yep, started in somewhat obscurity.
Casey Rivers picked up the foul the other night. You know, the Tigers are a physical ball club, but they may have to watch some of the moving screens tonight.
And there they handle that back cut, and somebody's trying to make that bounce pass. All the centers for West Virginia, and I guess Georgetown, you throw in the boot in the mix too, have to make plays.
One of the things Frank Smith, the assistant coach from Clemson, told me is when you're guarding the back cut, you guard it with two men, the passer and the cutter's defender right there, the deflection.
Now, if you're going to rest that pass, it makes it tougher.
Get out. Three-pointers there, Frank Young. He got the first three-pointer of the night on Tuesday.
Can you remember anybody getting that much better in 4 years, though?
No, it remarkable. 1 point a game to now averaging 24 in the NIT. And he has the green light, too, for this club.
Yeah, that caressing pressure, Ron.
And Frank again.
Yep.
Turns it over.
And Clemson will come right back now with their diamond 1-2-1-1 press.
And Mays really harasses the passer and steals the ball as well. It's dangerous in a sense. He gives some open looks for West Virginia.
Well, it's interesting. Air Force did not attack that press very much, and West Virginia may have a different strategy there.
Well, there's that good job fronting that cutter. They switched that little slice cut.
You're watching Nichols after what he did the other night. Jumper on the way, off the mark, the tip inside, no good. Rivers will come away with it. He gets it off quickly over to Hamilton.
And on the miss, they go straight up man. Good call.
It's going to be a travel. Our officials tonight, Pat Driscoll, the man who made the call, is our referee, and the two umpires, Joe Lindsay and Ted Hillary.
Now, Fran, I know Ron and I are close to the same age. It's amazing the foot speed of these guys. I mean, you've coached them.
Yes.
I mean, even causing that walk took an amazing amount of speed.
Oh, you're talking. I just done the official. I thought you meant the officials, and I mentioned Ted Hillary.
Well, he's
talking
right
about the players. I'm sorry.
No, I don't think there's any foot speed there with Ted Hillary.
Or us. Or us.
He's been faking it pretty good for a lot of years, though. He must know what's going on.
Clemson in four possessions has had three turnovers, so they got to find the handle. Ball will stay with the Tigers.
And you would expect early in the game for Clemson to be disruptive of West Virginia's offense, and early on it's been the other way.
The switching D's have confused them. Yep. Sykes in to shake it up a little bit, I think, for Clemson.
You notice, Billy, nobody has zone inbounds plays anymore. Everybody's throwing it out to midcourt.
They're afraid of a turnover, probably, right? Other than if you got a big guy you can lob to on occasion.
That Sykes open on the cutter. Couldn't get it to him. Driving the lane and scoring is made.
Pretty good adjustment with that left hand. And he's got the pressure. Plays that passing lane beautifully.
Bounce pass, almost not able to get it because of the angle he had to bounce it.
See, even when the press doesn't cause a turnover, much like the other night, it really limits now the shot clock for West Virginia.
Well, the wrong guy's ending up with the end of the press. You know, Alexander's not going to shoot it as confidently as a Ruoff might or a Young.
Nichols, shot clock is at five. Got to turn around and drop. The left-handed jumper from about 10 feet.
I'll tell you what.
You're so impressed with him.
He's getting a great start towards next season, Bill.
He sure is.
He does a little bit of everything from your point guard.
How about the way he just turns away from traffic?
Yep.
Hamilton on the run.
Boy, if you can beat that zone with the dribble, it can really help the kick pass, or if you can hit the floater.
Trap and they steal it. Mays got it and hands the ball off to Rivers for the easy two.
You know, that's what they need.
He told me early in the year, Mays, and I said, why do you like playing the point of the press? He says, because that's where I eat.
Look at nice screen off by Summers to get the goal.
Darris Nichols just goes coast to coast.
And Frank, getting back to Mays, the way he positions his body,
yes,
faces the ball, takes away one definite passing lane. Ooh, a little shove by Ruoff,
yeah.
Huh?
After the shove, got the ball about in the wing to Young. Three-pointer launch.
Yep.
Spread and you don't get out, you're going to pay for it.
Boy, six quick points for him. He had five quick ones on Tuesday. And this has to please that West Virginia coaching staff.
You know what, Ron? The coaches told me he has the green light to shoot a good shot any time in the shot clock. Good example right there.
Boy, that'll attract a lot of shooters out there paying attention.
Yeah.
Another left-handed three-pointer counted and a chance for a four-point play.
Wow, that was deep, too, and John Beilein shaking his head. You challenge, close that under control.
So let's take a timeout and one more look at the last play. Fouled on a three-point attempt, makes the shot. When we come back, he'll be at the free throw line. We are tied at 12-12 in our championship game. And let's go back inside the play in our big play on Tuesday night.
Well, so many things can happen in 2.1 seconds. First of all, Mississippi State coach Rick Stansbury is trying to call timeout. The officials obviously are watching the play. Then watch Nichols now in your spot shadow. He's going to decoy, acting like he wants a screen from 21, Frank Young. But he's going to head to the opposite corner, a little misdirection, the catch. And he couldn't even see the rim when he let it go, and he knocked it down. And John Beilein came up with this play. He'd run it once before this season. He got it from Danny Nee, my old mentor, when he was coaching at Duquesne.
And that's the first thing he said in the post game.
Yep.
And he gave him credit.
Absolutely.
It's almost like you tell somebody else's joke at a dinner.
But he said that he ran it for Duquesne against him, and Danny's kid missed the shot. Mm-hmm. And when he came out for a clean, he said, show me that play.
Show me that play.
Show me the money.
Well, he made the free throw, so it's a four-point play following the long three-pointer. And Franz punched it up by one.
And Rodney, you had said it wouldn't be a bad idea where the coach goes to the official timer.
Yeah.
And like international basketball, and can call that timeout.
Yeah,
could
right.
have a better setup defensively. Maybe zoned it.
That's right, Bill, because it's very hard for the officials to really hear or see the other coach trying to get the timeout.
That's
the
off.
The last thing they're going to look at is down the other end in a play like that.
And you see how each time West Virginia scores, they're able to set up this 1-3-1.
Oh, a little fumble here. What a break for the Clemson Tigers.
See, with the three defenders, Billy, I think you got to attack this from the corner in.
Well, now look at the size, too.
Yes.
I mean, you got Smalligan
is in
yep.
there.
I think you've got to make him a non-player.
Right.
You know, whether it's the corner or an elbow, keep him occupied somehow.
But after our game tonight, right here on ESPN, make sure to check out your favorite college basketball players at the State Farm College Basketball Slam Dunk and Three-Point Shooting Championship. For more information, log on to ESPN.com. And I know some of the guys we're going to be watching, particularly the three-point shooting, AC Law from Texas A&M.
Well, he's got that knuckleball sideways spin that manages to go in.
Also, Mr. Falls from Notre Dame.
Yep.
Very, very accomplished from that distance.
I think he won last year. I'm going to take Falls this year. I think
that's a good bet.
You're taking a fall.
I've taken a few in my lifetime, mostly before 10.
Boy, second foul on Young. And John Beilein's got a decision to make right here. And the difficult thing is, he's hit back-to-back three-point buckets. But now, the question is, how long do you have to sit him on the bench? This happens at the 12:46 mark. Bill, you first. I mean, you know what?
Well, it's easy. You know, a lot of guys are going for the two. The only thing I like is to get him back at some point if you can do an offense.
Right.
A minute or two. Maybe steal a minute and get him back out. A lot of guys will go, John Chaney, have him sit for 12, 14 minutes in his day, and it worked. So I think it's really a personal, how deep you are. What would you do?
I think it's partly the scoreboard, too.
Sure, you're in it.
You know, if Clemson gets out in front here, it's also the last game of the year. You know, I got to think you could take some chances with your best player, mm-hmm. too. Why waste them?
Nice back cut. That's what happens when they pressure.
Nichols got it right back to Alexander. Made a nice move to get around the defender, Booker, but didn't miss the shot.
Now here's an open shot frequently, and we'll pass it up to get into traffic. And that time didn't come up with the crayon. Needed a left hand that close to the rim. Went back into the defense.
Dishes to Booker, lost the handle, regained it and scored.
Well, if you can get it down there, the baseline guy is your point guard. And it's hard to get it there.
Yep. And with that young man, Booker's got great hands, too, when he does get his mitts on it.
Well, listen, for only a freshman,
mm-hmm.
he doesn't have a big upside. He's got a real big upside. And his younger brother.
Oh, his arm or his hand. Oh, my goodness. Alexander, he is hurting. Stuck his arm in there. Almost like maybe the shoulder too, Fran, the way he went
yes.
in, huh?
Yep.
Oh.
Wow. So we take one more look at the collision. Already Young on the bench. Looked as though maybe hyperextended it just a bit. We'll be right back. Clemson on top. 7 lead changes, 5 ties already. Both of our semifinal games 2 nights ago were 1-point victories. Let's go back and look at what happened just a moment ago when Alexander was injured. Watch for number 11. He gets his arm caught in the middle here. And it looks as though, yes, that it hyperextends that the elbow. Now, they have not broken the huddle, so he's standing up right now, and nobody's attending to him. But I don't think he's going to come right back on the floor right now, Fran.
Well, you're right. And, you know, thankfully, it looks like he'll be okay. But this puts John Beilein in a little bit of a quandary. Frank Young picks up the 2 fouls. Alexander's going to have to sit for a while, Bill. So that's how you develop your bench, I guess.
At this late in the year, you don't want to be developing, though,
yeah,
right?
I know it.
But, you know, when these kids get hurt like that and you cringe, you know it's serious. I mean, if he's able to come back, good for him. But he, in the huddle, wasn't really grabbing it and massaging it. So maybe the initial shock, and then hopefully it's worn off.
Wellington Smith has checked into the ball game at number 35, replacing him. Jamie Smaldigan will stay at number 43, the seven-footer for West Virginia.
Ruoff on the one wing. And one of the bigger guys can rebound, but this is where I think you have to attack somehow.
That's a long group of guys out there. It is. 1-3-1.
Nice assist, and the shot was missed from point-blank range by Tyler.
This will give Smith a chance, one of those young guys, Summit, New Jersey kid, Blair Academy.
Wow, Smaldigan. It took him about three or four of those to warm up for the three-pointer the other night.
I almost want to say nice shot by Pitsnagel. That's reminiscent, isn't it? He does have some range.
Has a lot fewer markings on his body.
That he does.
There's that trap in the corner. Yep.
Just give it up.
Smaldigan gets it off to Rioff. I'll tell you what, that was really good anticipation on the part of Clemson. And a foul is called on Butler.
Yeah, just grab so you can go the other end. Want to give up that fast break. But great hustle and a recovery by Clemson.
You're right. Hammonds quickly jumped in that passing lane. Look, here's the trap. And you see the deflection out. Looks like it's going to go the other way. And terrific play by Hammonds to break up that break.
And Hamilton ready to go the other way.
John Beilein grabbed Smaldigan after the ball, after we had the whistle, and was explaining to him that the pass created a situation for the foul, but he had a man on the wing that he should have thrown the ball to.
He might have made that big threes on the floor now.
Mays pushes it off, reversal, and the score by Trevor Booker.
Now that's the area, I
yes,
think.
Yes.
You know, drive that lane at the elbow, make two play one, and a little kick here on the break, and take advantage of that situation. I don't think you can go perimeter around.
Well, that's exactly right, boy. That's what I meant by you say elbow, I say corner area, but you're exactly right. Perfect dribble drive. Then there's the kick that spreads the defense.
And now you got the choice if you want to kick, too.
Excellent.
Great look. And as you mentioned, the hands underneath on the pass.
Because it's really hard to attack from out top with the three guys, especially the big guy at the foul line.
Joe Mazzulla checks in. And a break for Darius Nichols. Boy, in the corner, nobody picked up the newest guy on the floor, Wellington Smith. The tip, second try, wouldn't go. And this one, who tipped it in?
I think it was Butler or Summers. Summers was kept it alive anyhow.
But that basket allows them to stay in this 1-3-1, and you see the length of Butler out top. See, I really think they added this defense at West Virginia, Bill, because it's a good defense for people with slow feet. Ganzi was terrific at the top.
Look at this, by the way, Fred. I think the thing. Don't you love it? It's like Air Force is playing.
Tell you what, Mazzulla came in and used his body nicely to protect the ball and also to bang the would-be participant who was gonna grab it for Clemson.
You know, when P.J. Colosimo got the Seton Hall job, he ran the 1-3-1, and it really did confuse people because you're the only team in the league using it. And West Virginia, if you haven't seen this, it's like the wishbone, Ron. Do I know my football?
On Thanksgiving, I know you do. This is Potter. He travels. That is six turnovers against Clemson. And Oliver Purnell is not real pleased with his ball club right now, although they're only down by one. And for those just joining us, Tuesday night, both of our semifinal games were one-point victories. Not just West Virginia winning at the buzzer, but Air Force came back and closed it to one. But the Tigers held on.
Billy, you talk about that 1-3-1 of PJ's. I saw the game at the Lapchick tournament where they knocked off nationally ranked Alabama.
And it was Wagner.
Yes, he was.
Yeah, I do remember. And then I think they lost to St. John's.
Yes.
Right?
The coach at Alabama is in this building tonight.
CM.
Yeah, CM Newton.
He didn't lose too often either. But again, those wrinkles, it's tough for kids to adjust on the fly.
Good look.
Yep.
Little skip pass. Doesn't pay off. Potter with a rebound, whistle, and a foul inside. Now let's check in with Scott Reese for a SportsCenter 30 at 30 update.
All right, Ron, Michael Phelps continues to be otherworldly. The American swimmer setting his third world record in as many days, winning the 200 individual medley at the World Championships in Melbourne, Australia. And some baseball. Tigers pitcher Kenny Rogers will miss at least one regular season start. He is on the 15-day DL with what they are calling a tired arm. Further details on SportsCenter 11 Eastern and all the time on ESPN News. Ron?
All righty, thanks, Scott. Nice job, Wellington Smith, just driving, coming full circle, so to speak.
A Jersey guy, they got to learn to go full circle.
Do you think Digger will lay claim to Michael Phelps being related?
He keeps winning these gold medals.
He likes the gold. Summers thinks he got it all, so did John Beilein over there.
So we'll take a timeout as we break. 7:41 left until halftime, and it's West Virginia 22-19. 22-19, West Virginia. Reminder, from 64-4, the Women's NCAA Championship continues on ESPN Sunday with both Final Four games. First at 7 Eastern, Rutgers will take on the LSU. Then at 9, it's North Carolina against Tennessee. Coverage begins 6:30 Eastern with the Women's Championship Special. Guys, here's a little trivia for you. Some notes about this ball game and related people. Most people forget that Tommy Bowden, the head football coach at Clemson, graduated from West Virginia. Mm-hmm. And that Rich Rodriguez was the offensive coordinator at Clemson 1999 and also the year 2000. And those two coaches visited the other's campus for spring training this past week. Rodriguez was at Clemson on Monday. And I understand both are watching tonight.
Why are you telling two basketball guys this stuff? You know, you just had some extra material from the end of the season.
Two schools in a game, Fran. I'm sorry. Are Clemson and West Virginia? I know that went right over your head.
Why does it surprise me you knew those connections?
Well, I don't know, Billy. Both coaches also, by the way, you haven't mentioned, were ringing the NASDAQ bell today. Did you realize that?
No, I don't get up that early. I was ringing my own bell.
I thought you meant you have no investments.
Right. Very few.
Well, there is one common denominator, and that's Bobby Bowden, the great coach of Florida State, who spent many years at West Virginia.
Yep, sure did. But Florida State's not playing tonight, so that's the reason I didn't mention it. His son graduated there. Never mind.
Well, at least you're on top of spring ball. I like that.
You did know Jerry West went to West Virginia, though, I'm sure, right?
I refuse to answer that. 5 seconds down to 4. Butler way outside, and I think that the big fella Booker got a hand on that one because it was well short.
Do you notice, Fran, that when they do dribble, they sometimes end up with a tough shot, but when they move the ball in themselves, and they end up with open looks.
And I think the problem sometimes is when they do move the ball, Clemson has a chance to take them out of that rhythm we talked about.
Mm-hmm. Well, Casey Rivers well off the mark on that three-point attempt right there. At the other end, Nichols got it.
And that gets back to your statement earlier. He makes great decisions. He had an option to kick it, but he had body control, not the charge.
You know, Radford High School, where he went, a very small school, and Clemson was one of the final choices for that young guy.
Boy, Hamilton really unfortunate there. That ball did everything but go down.
And Ruoff's on the wing if he wants him again.
Nichols shoots it short, but it'll come right back to Wellington Smith.
You know, he reminds me of Bill, Derek Fisher.
That's true.
Lefty.
Good jump shooter.
Yep.
Can play crafty.
A
yep. Plays a combo.
Three-pointer too hard off the back iron. Can he retrieve it? Yes.
And Smart went up, took an overview. And a good delivery.
Figures if he took a quick shot, he better get the rebound.
Deshaun Butler.
He's only going to be a quick hook. Nice back cut, a little step and go. Pretty.
Well, he saw Booker coming at him, had to pull up so there wouldn't be an offensive charge.
How many times this year, Ron, have we seen those guards shoot those little runners in the lane, avoid that contact?
You guys have had some great games in the Big 12, haven't you?
Oh, boy.
Had 5 overtime games to begin with, let alone the buzzer beaters.
Nice hustle again.
Butler right there to clean it up.
Wow.
And now a 6-point lead, and Oliver says, might better talk this over. Schull will take a timeout for 30 seconds. 5:32 left until the halftime, and West Virginia with a little... Ron Franklin along with Fran Fraschilla and the Governor, Bill Raftery, from the MasterCard NIT Championship game right here in New York City, Madison Square Garden. This is an 8-1 run on the part of West Virginia. And Bill, we were just talking during the timeout. Booker, again, you look, you see that freshman sign by his name, but I think more maturing in his years as far as basketball IQ. Two straight plays, he really helped out there.
And Fran and I were disappointed the rest of the team didn't come back on that block to help. They gave up the goal.
Interesting, guys. This run has been without Frank Young, who sits down with those two fouls.
Rivers, good job of hustle right there. Fran, you're right. Alexander still on the bench. Young, I beg your pardon, Alexander back out on the floor, but Young is the man who's still sitting.
Butler's got a blow now, and Butler, Bill, I think will be the guy that replaces Young in terms of that scoring next year.
I think you're right. He's really played some good basketball here. They get to the rim and unfortunately unable to convert.
Hamilton out of the wing to Hamilton. Rivers.
A nice check out. Small again, playing big again.
Alexander got the rebound and all the way at the other end. A hard foul right there by Raymond Sykes.
We mentioned Missoula the other night. I've seen enough of him this year that in this system, by the time he gets to be a junior, he's going to be a very solid point guard.
Another combo guard. Look at this step and go. You don't miss Smith twice at the rim.
Twice. Let me correct something. There was no foul called on the play.
You know what? I think I'd zone West Virginia on out of bounds after the other night of that one.
4-point lead, West Virginia.
Good help.
Short. And again, the checkout. Nice play. I think they give Rivers the wraparound.
Yep, sure did. Two fouls on Rivers. And now, very quickly to the bench, Oliver Purnell looks over and says, we're going to have Rivers come over and sit down with us.
And Young in, we talked about when to put him in, and he wants a little offense now coming down the stretch. You're mature, you've been around, don't foul.
In case you joined us late, Frank, Young had two quick three-pointers and also picked up his second foul.
That's what he does, Mays. I'm telling you.
Got it away, and Smalligan really a little bit slow, a little lazy on the pass.
While they get it, they made him pass to the big guy. That's perfect.
That time, Smalligan was slow again.
Not thinking again.
And that's enough again.
But I'll tell you, James Mays is one of those guys you don't run any plays for. He gets it off of the glass, gets it off the defense.
Show one more look at that turnover hoop just a moment ago. See, Mays got those long arms out there and scored the easy putback. '26-24 our score. 10 lead changes, 5 ties. Largest lead, 6 points by West Virginia. And the biggest on 8-1, and that also by the Mountaineers. But considering on Tuesday night both semifinal games were 1-point decisions, this one here looks like it's headed for the stretch run also as we get a 3-pointer.
Out of bounds play. Oh, that's their best offense.
What did you just say about you thinking so?
Just a little screen and opening up and taking advantage of Young. He's on the floor, let him shoot it.
Those are the little things that point out when a team is really well coached. Scoring off inbounds plays.
And look at the size here.
Nichols got a hand on that.
There he goes.
Yep.
4 in a row.
Green light.
Well, they push with the dribble. He fades and converts.
4 for 4, Billy.
Wow.
Billy, you remember his sophomore year here when he had to start in place of Tyrone Sally?
Yeah, I do.
And that was the beginning of Frank Young as a quality player that the end sophomore year in the Big East tournament.
He likes the guard, and Ruoff is just a little bit late, and they get a little grab underneath.
This is an amazing story. 1 point a game as a freshman. His sophomore year, he stepped in for Tyrone Sally in the Big East tournament. And ever since then, and particularly this season, guys, a go-to guy.
And Fran, do you notice when teams run the floor, it opens it up for the second tier people?
The gold shirts were underneath the rim. You got to follow them and address that, and it leaves them open. It's almost impossible to contest.
Frank Young, surprisingly, is getting a rest, but I think the head coach thought, whoa, he's 4 for 4. Well, let's don't get that third foul right here.
Correct, Ron.
Very glad that number 11, Joe Alexander, is off that bench and okay, because he was in some kind of pain when that slight hyperextension of the arm occurred. Hamilton, offensive foul.
Boy, they really had them jumbled up, didn't they? From the double on the box, the looping diagonal, everything. Trying to get into the right spot as quickly, but better defense.
Hamilton thought he had a crease, and they closed quickly.
It's 10 turnovers against the Tigers in this half.
Uh-oh, gee whiz. Over you. You know, isn't it interesting? Dean Smith did that for years. You know, the high post entry, he would put the ball over the head, and I used to, me, I would suggest to the coach, everybody knows what you're going to do, belling, you know, to get to the finals every year. But that's what happened there, Ruoff. What could he do? He couldn't protect, he couldn't maneuver, didn't work his guy.
That's right, couldn't throw a bounce pass.
Yeah, and he was toing while the ball was throwing, and it went well over his head.
You know, they run almost like Texas Tech, by the way. They make you get back, and they won't take a bad shot.
And the guys that run the floor don't get credit for it until you get into the film room.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Look at this. They don't get out. The little screen and pop. Wow.
Smalligan.
You know what's interesting, guys? Smalligan was wide open on that break. That's why the crowd went nuts. They didn't find him. So what did he do? He waited his turn, knocked down the three.
They don't foul in this 1-3-1 as well, which is a big entity.
Shot clock is about to hit 10. It does right now. Well, West Virginia contingent making a lot of noise. Skip pass. Hamilton.
They're going to end up with no shot. No shot.
They did not get it off. And a standing ovation for those that are here from Morgantown, and for good reason. Nice job defensively.
One day you can't prepare for this 1-3-1, and the bigs able to make shots. Smalligan, but how about this? You know, we value research.
Yes.
Ted Hillary's son was taught violin by Smalligan's mother.
How about that?
How about that in grade school?
Back in Indiana.
Well, Ted's, I said, well, you didn't teach him how to shoot the ball. In Lansing, I believe.
Oh,
yeah.
That's right. You got a lot of people that have driven up Interstate 81, Ron.
Now look at this, the ability to get offensive. This punishes you. You can't give them opportunities. And properly served by the Butler.
They are now 8 of 13 from beyond the arc. Smalligan 2 of 2, and Frank Young is 4 of 4.
Boy, quick burst can bury you.
12-0 on the run.
How about Smalligan here? Keep your eye on him right there. They run this offense. He sets the screen and pops. And Billy, this is Pitsnoggle stuff right there.
Same play.
That's the play. Set the screen. His man has to help. He gets to the line and knocks it down. And then watch Smalligan's kick out right here to the freshman.
How about that? A little sleight of hand, though. Look one way. A little nylon out of jersey. And you're pretty good friends with his high school coach,
Nick Marinello.
Yeah.
From Bloomfield Tech stepped by before the game.
My first captain, Gary Cavallo, his wife works with Nick.
Yeah.
Small world.
Well, it's interesting because Butler, Ron, is one of those guys that was a top 100 player. One of the rare guys that John Beilein gets that's heavily recruited. So he's going to be a nice player and probably Young's replacement. as Young graduates.
Speaking of Young, they're now saying officially he had another three-pointer early in the ball game. And so he's 4 of 5 rather than 4 of 4. His head coach doesn't care. Rivers, strong to the hoop, and he gets it by Smalling.
Boy, if you can handle that double, you're going to get something.
That's
on that
right.
Kick. Well, you know what? I think they've got to go to the foul line for the diagonal just to help the passer out a little bit.
I always taught my post guys, when you catch it, always look middle right away so you can see the double and you can see the help.
Now, how smart is Butler now? He was going to shoot it, but he knows they got last possession. And they learned quickly under John Beilein.
Well, Mays tries for the steal, not there. And Casey Rivers gambled and made the nice defensive steal.
Well, you got to know the clock to save it. And that's what he's upset about. Gives them the hammer here.
Rock again.
Three-pointer on the way. Did not go.
Alexander quickly runs off the floor
and hides.
Yo, let me beat the coach and maybe you'll forget.
So, gentlemen, West Virginia closes the first half with a run of 12-2. And as a result, they lead it 38-26. Now let's go to Scott Reese in the studio.